Hey guys, in this video we'll see how to navigate using Compose destinations. Let's see what's inside our app. So we launch this application. We see we are presented with sign in with Google. So let's click on that. Signing in, we see we are presented with our home screen. The second time when we launch the app, we are not presented with the sign in and we straight away go to the home screen. Here we can do some operations. Let's add a to do. Now let's save it. And we see we are presented with the to do. We can update this to do. We can delete this to do and we can add a new one again. As you just saw, all these navigations like moving from add to do to this screen, or going back, or even coming to the home screen in the first place uses some type of navigation. So let's go into the detail. In the Compose navigation, we first create a navigation component. So this is basically a Kotlin class where we have defined all our destinations. For example, auth, home, and the add to do. All our routes are placed inside NavHost. So NavHost is basically, it provides in place the Compose hierarchy for self-contained navigation. And this basically also requires a nav controller. This nav controller is provided us by Remember Nav Controller, which basically creates a NavHost controller that handles the navigation. These are all our destinations present in the app. So there are three. Auth stands for auth. Home takes in a parameter user. And add to do is for add to do. Since our auth should be the first route, we mentioned that in our nav host by making it as a start destination. Inside our auth view, once we receive the required data from the Google sign in, we convert it into a user object and then we pass it to our destinations. Since our destination had that parameter user, we simply replace that with the entire JSON object. Back inside our navigation component, we access the parameter which was sent from auth to the home screen using backstack entry. We get the parameter user and then we convert it into a user model. Finally, we pass it to the home view. For simple apps, when the app is at a small level, it's okay to use this kind of approach. But as your app scales, maybe you can have some problems. So for example, in the auth view, where we had to create or we had to replace our user with that user object and then access using backstack entry. So let's see how we can do better using Compose destinations. As per the documentation, Compose destination is a KSP library that processes annotations and generates code. Internally, it itself uses the Compose navigation. Let's head over to our build.gradle and add in these lines inside the dependencies. The versions which we are using for Compose destination is present in versions.gradle and this is basically 1.4.2. Next, we need to add the KSP plugin inside the build.gradle itself, and followed by we will be adding the source sets for the debug and the release flavor inside our Kotlin block. So this block basically defines the path where the generated code will reside, since the Compose destinations uses KSP for code generation. Let's see our auth screen composable. So here we have added the annotation destination, and this annotation basically comes from the Compose destination itself. And here we have specified as start is true, which means that, hey, this composable is our first screen to be launched. Next, inside the parameters of auth screen, we specify the type to be destinations navigator, which is basically an interface on top of your nav controller. We do the same for our home view composable, where we specify the annotation destination. And nextly, we convert the nav controller to destinations navigator. Finally, we do the same logic for our add to do view composable, which is followed by @destination annotation and changing the nav controller to be destination's navigator. Now we run this command gradlew clean build, which will help in the code generation by our compose destination. After the successful completion of our build gradle, we now should be able to view our generated files inside our KSP Kotlin, and we see here there are some destinations which correspond to our composables, like auth screen destination for our auth composable, home view destination for our home view composable, and addToDoView destination for our addToDoView composable. This also comprises of a nav graphs. To tie this all up, inside our main activity, we use the destination's nav host, which comes from the compose destination, and this requires navgraph to be passed, which is navgraph.root. And if you guys recall, this was the same file which we saw in the generated folder. Since we are using this destination's nav host, we no longer require the previous created navigation component or the destinations. So we have removed or deleted that navigation component as well as the destinations. And for the navigation part, we simply use the destination which is from the generated file. So in this case, let's say we want to navigate to addToDoView. We simply call the nav controller navigate and pass in our destinations, which is addToDoView destination. So this is how our addToDoView destination looks like. It comprises of a route ID and some generated stuff required for the compose destinations. Now from the auth screen, we need to pass a custom parameter, which is the Google user model. So let's see how we did it. We create a parcelize class, which is Google user model. And for using parcelize, we simply added the plugin Kotlin parcelize in our build.gradle. Inside our home view, we still have those two parameters as nav controller and user model. But now let's see what's inside our auth view now. Inside our auth view, we pass in the home view destination, but now we also pass in the Google user model. In case this gives you an error, simply run the command again gradlew clean build, since you need to update your destination, and which would also take a required parameter of Google user model now. If we navigate to the home view destination, this is how it looks like. It comprises of an invoke function which takes in a user model. The route itself is generated as route ID slash parameterized user model. And this is taken care all by our compose destination. In the cases where you require popping up to some route, you simply mention the route name as destination's route ID. So in this case, we have used auth screen destination's route ID. And this is nothing but the auth screen destination's route ID, which was generated by the compose destinations. Let's verify the behavior now. We again click on our app. So as we had already signed in, it should launch us back to the home screen. Let's add some to-do. We save the to-do, go back, we update it, clear it. Everything works perfect. We also verify the sign in Google case. So we click on the app again. We are presented with the auth screen. Now we click on the sign in Google. And yes, we are able to sign in and see our home screen. That's it from this video, guys. If you like this video, share, subscribe, and comment.